Right now, as you're watching this video, about 20 volcanoes are erupting around the world. And while some of their summits have been continuously spitting out clouds of ash for months at a time, others have just woken up. You might not have known about these volcanic statistics before the video began, but imagine if such a horrifying sight, a freshly erupting volcano, appeared out your window right now under your very eyes. You would probably need to run away as fast and as far as possible to get away from the hot, spewing lava and the deadly pyroclastic cloud. But indeed, one day, there may be nowhere to run away to. Scientists count a total of 1,532 volcanoes on the surface of the Earth, at least at the moment. Fortunately, during the entire period of human existence, only 600 of them have ever been active. 160 volcanoes erupt about once every decade, with about 50 erupting annually. Thankfully, most of them are fairly small volcanoes, relatively speaking, and don't do much damage or cause any harm. But if one of the most formidable and awe-inspiring of these mountains of fire for some reason decided to run at its full capacity, believe it or not, the whole planet could find itself in trouble. Among these earth-threatening mega-sized volcanoes is one called Mount Merapi, or Gunung Merapi in Indonesian, which literally means Fire Mountain. Located in the central part of the island of Java, this most active volcano in all Indonesia has a height of 1.8 miles, or about 3 kilometers. This ticking time bomb, though not erupting at the moment, continues to emit smoke all day, every day, reminding the nearby settlements of its existence and destructive power. Every few years, this fire mountain turns into erupting hell, damaging or destroying nearby cities and towns. Another one of these potentially earth-destroying uber volcanoes is situated on the other side of the globe, in the central part of the North American continent, and is known as the Yellowstone Supervolcano. This huge megavolcano has erupted only 3 times in all of history, the last time being about 630,000 years ago. And each time it did erupt, it caused massive, world-altering cataclysms. Mountain ranges were destroyed. The Earth itself rose. Over the eons, the summit collapsed and created a giant pit in the Earth, a super crater now known as the Yellowstone Caldera. Its width varies from between 30 to 45 miles. That's 50 to 70 kilometers. That's one big volcano. In more recent history, America's first national park, Yellowstone, was established encompassing the entire beautiful and breathtaking area. It's certainly the most famous national park in the USA and is well known throughout the world. Both the park and the volcano take their name from the Yellowstone River, whose headwaters are within the confines of the park. But even today, the at-the-moment dormant Yellowstone supervolcano continues to pose an enormous threat to mankind. In the case of an eruption, the USA would be utterly devastated, with a good half of the American states getting buried in ash. And multiple knock-on effects would shatter much of the world's ecosystems and economies. People who enjoy traveling and moving to new cities and locales will be more than happy to settle near Mount Vesuvius, located in the Gulf of Naples. This is because each of Vesuvius' eruptions guarantees instant emigration to another city. At present, Vesuvius is said to be sleeping, but don't let that fool you. It's also still considered to be one of the most dangerous volcanoes in the world, as more than 3 million people live nearby and are endangered by it. But as it is sleeping, the title of City Destroyer must pass to Nyiragongo, at least for the moment. Mount Nyiragongo is a still active fire mountain or volcano on the African continent, in Virunga National Park, in the Democratic Republic of Congo. Mount Nyiragongo has erupted 34 times since 1882, with activity continuing for months and sometimes even years. This volcano is remarkable in that its crater contains an active lava lake. In 1977, part of the crater collapsed and the hot lava inside burst out, with the fiery stream moving at speeds of up to 62 miles or 100 kilometers an hour, devouring, incinerating, and destroying everything in its path. The crater filled again soon after, but scientists and engineers have so far managed to prevent a new lava spill. Alas, it may be deadly dangerous, but still the lava lake on top of Mount Nyiragongo looks so beautiful and picturesque, you might believe that Frodo should have brought the One Ring here. But if one supervolcanic awakening can bring worldwide catastrophe, what might happen if all the volcanoes on our lovely planet all erupted simultaneously? A synchronized volcanic doomsday event such as we are imagining would lead to such terrible consequences that even multiple nuclear explosions might not match it. The concomitant earthquakes and lava flows would already obviously cause tremendous damage, but they are nothing compared to the twin threats of ash and volcanic gases. Under such a scenario, a layer of ash will rise into the atmosphere and almost completely block any sunlight from reaching the Earth. Good news for sellers of flashlights and light bulbs. Pretty awful news for everyone else. This darkness will last for 10 years, which means no photosynthesis, the death of all plants, and temperatures decreasing to a critical level. Of course, not all volcanoes clog up the atmosphere. The ones in Hawaii are a good example. They just spew small streams of lava. However, the most active, largest, and most powerful of these volcanoes will cover entire continents with ash in a matter of hours. But as we have learned in modern times how to disperse clouds somewhat, you might think we could manage to do something about these ash clouds as well. And we might. But is there anything we could possibly do about the volcanic gases? These gases are a death-filled cocktail of hydrochloric acid, hydrogen, hydrogen sulfide, and sulfur dioxide. Shake well, add water, and you get an acid rain that pollutes all of our groundwater, as well as the surface of all of our oceans. Changes in the composition of the water will lead to the death of corals and mollusks, and after that, species after species will fall in a domino effect, with eventually the entire food chain likely disappearing. You might think the chance of something like this happening is vanishingly small, and it is very unlikely, but not impossible. A comparative analysis of ancient sedimentary rock formations revealed that the mass disappearance of prehistoric fauna was caused by multiple volcanic eruptions. Fortunately, volcanologists from Radford University in Virginia have determined that in our time, such a development is truly quite unlikely. But if it does happen, there'll be almost no one to assess the damage. Everyone left will just be trying their best to survive the apocalyptic end times. However, even a single solitary eruption can adversely affect the atmosphere. A recent example is the Mount Pinatubo volcano in the Philippines, which erupted in 1991. One of the strongest explosions on Earth over the last century, it led to a decrease in temperature of 1 degree Fahrenheit, or about 0.6 degrees Celsius, and caused the ozone hole over Antarctica in the southern hemisphere to increase to unprecedented size. Thankfully, so far, nothing indicates that this kind of catastrophe is going to happen again anytime soon. But don't sigh with relief and kick your feet up just yet. The fact is that our land-based volcanoes are just a small percentage of the total number of volcanoes on our dear planet. Scientists believe that about 80% of all volcanic eruptions happen under our oceans, most of them thousands of feet deep and very difficult to spot. Recently, though, geophysicists from the University of Texas discovered a super-duper-uber volcano at the bottom of the Pacific Ocean, in theory, capable of turning our entire surface world into one big Pompeii. This volcano is located at a distance of 932 miles or 1,500 kilometers from the east coast of Japan. If we look at the area the object covers, we can rightfully call it the largest volcano on the surface of our planet, and indeed, in the entire solar system. The diameter of the crater reaches an astounding 388 miles, or 625 kilometers, and its area covers a mind-bogglingly massive 100,386 square miles. That's 160,000 square kilometers. This monster volcano goes by the moniker the Tamu Massif, and volcanologists say that it fell asleep more than 140 million years ago. Thank goodness it has not shown any proclivity towards waking up from its slumber since. It's unknown when the volcano might one day awaken once more. But one thing is clear. If Tamu's sleep comes to an end, the best solution will be for all of us to find another planet to live on. Fortunately for us, mankind has recently been considering Mars as a kind of second home, a potential refuge for all of us in the case of world-ending earthly catastrophes, and that includes volcanoes. But there is one little problem, or rather I should say big problem. The tallest volcano in the entire solar system is called Olympus Mons, and it just so happens to be located on, yes, you guessed it, the red planet. This giant has a height of more than 16 miles, or 26 kilometers, with its diameter stretching for 335 miles, or 540 kilometers. Hypothetically, conquering the summit of Olympus Mons shouldn't be all that difficult, due to its gently sloping sides. Mountain climbers of the future are going to be a little disappointed. But I would advise they take a pair of skis or a snowboard. The descent is gonna be hella awesome. Olympus Mons is a volcano that formed under conditions somewhat like that of a melting candle. Lava streams flowed down the slopes and froze there over and over again, continually increasing the total area of the massif. Analysis of images from the USA's Mars rover showed that the peak of the fiery mountain's activity occurred between 20 and 200 million years ago, when dinosaurs still roamed the Earth. However, the most recent traces of activity on the mountain are only about 2 million years old. This means that Olympus Mons may not be extinct, but is rather a sleeping volcano. And if it awakens once more from its slumber, it will be an historical event in our solar system. To understand just how truly massive Olympus Mons really is, let's move it to the surface of the Earth to compare it to some Earth landmarks. The area it covers is comparable to that of all of the British Isles. Or looked at another way, just its shadow would completely engulf Mount Everest, and in true size, it leaves Everest in the dust, making our tallest Earth mountain look like some kind of tiny little bump on the horizon. Olympus Mons is so big that standing at the top looking down, all you can see is the smooth slope disappearing beyond the curve of the horizon. It's literally impossible to view it all from the planet itself. The entire massif can only be seen from orbit, so if you want to leave a message for some spacefarers, the slopes of this volcano are an ideal place to leave it, at least until some new lava flows cover it up. Nonetheless, it's still too early to worry about another eruption. Unlike the Earth, Mars has no tectonic plates. This means that Olympus Mons could snooze away for a very long time. But if an eruption does happen one day, and you are living there, it will literally overshadow the sun. If Mars turns out to be more inhospitable than we imagined, scientists will have to think hard and long about a plan B. What do you think? Where could humanity move? Or if we don't move, how might we adapt to the consequences of such a catastrophe? Please leave your theories in the comments below. If this video gets a lot of likes and we get a lot of comments about potential places for people to inhabit in the universe, we'll devote one of our future episodes to this topic. So, if you like the video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. Click on the bell button to be the first to know about new videos. And stay tuned, because the best is yet to come.